photograph for you. Miss Marge!
Miss Kirk, the money order is on the table. Christopher Columbus. Thank you, Professor. Another publisher?
I do not know. I do not read your letters.
They keep arriving.
I keep bringing them to you.
Hoping. We all keep hoping for your success, Miss Marge.
The whole boarding house keeps hoping. We have all of us on edge.
My dear Miss March, I have read your story. Read it. Unfortunately, I found your tale tasteless and vulgar, not at all suitable for my readers. My advice to you.
My advice to you is to go home and have babies. That is what women are made for. Sincerely, F. Putnam.
22 rejections since I've been in New York. They all say the same thing. Go home.
Give up.
F. Putnam's words are stupid.
F. Putnam is the most powerful publisher in New York.
You cannot lose faith, Miss Marge. There will be somebody out there that will like your story. I'm certain of it.
Professor, would you mind listening to my story? I would so respect your opinion.
Yes, of course.
Do my best. It's a mean, stormy night. The moors are bleak and bloody. Thunder claps. Lightning strikes. The fair Clarissa, clothed in disarray, races across the wild coast. Now she stops. Now she runs. Will she escape? Will she be caught? With bold determination, the villainous aristocrat Braxton Prendergast lurches for her. There's no escape. She's but a child, and yet she turns to fight with eyes ablaze.
I cannot keep away. Your beauty draws me. Your passion ignites me. I've got to hold you.
I defy you.
Got to have you.
Let me buy you.
Come close.
Don't come too close.
Come close.
Don't come too close.
So close, so close to me. I'll have her, and the mother too.
And at that moment, Rodrigo appears in magnificent splendor.
Unhand that woman, Billy.
Who are you?
Who are you?
Such a conversation as this. Now I will go to dinner. Miss March, you have been here 6 weeks now, was it? You shout, you rant, you upset this whole boarding house. I am as serene and peaceful now.
You're aloof, you're arrogant.
Arrogant? I spoke my mind as you spoke yours. Obviously, it was not appreciated on either side.
Obviously, my stories were a great success in Concord. Better, better.
incredible human being.
Mr. Lawrence, he's over there glaring out the window. He looks sinister. I think he looks sad.
I wouldn't be sad living in such a house. Has anyone ever been inside?
He never let any of us in.
I hear he's a very angry man. Joel's gonna get us all into debt and trouble. We'll be known as a family with the criminal sister.
What criminal sister?
Mario!
With what?
I'll plant six more.
12.
And I'll chop your firewood for a few days.
Weeks. And I hope such an incident never happens again. You've ruined my day.
Do read it, Marmee.
Josephine? Josephine, is that you? Josephine!
Good morning, Aunt Mark.
Do you know the hour?
Almost 10, I believe.
Your workday starts to me at 9. You must read it to me. And you still fix the latch on the cellar door.
Busy finding this beautiful flower.
Don't try to look at Josephine, we're dawdling.
I wasn't dawdling. I'm writing a story.
You are what happens to a girl when she has no father.
I have a father.
Never here when you need him. And now my nephew has the audacity to go be an army chaplain when he can't even support his own family. Listen to me, Josephine. You're on the verge of womanhood. And look at you, going about writing senseless stories, trying to save everyone. You can't even save yourself.
I need saving.
There are many pitfalls a girl can fall into, Josephine, and you're heading towards all of them. If you can't be rich, you can at least marry well.
I'll never marry.
You'll marry. All girls marry.
I'm not all girls.
With a good marriage, you can find power. Take your place in society.
I don't give two figs about society.
Well, no point having this conversation, then. It's clear to me I can never take you to Europe. It was an idle thought of mine.
George, do you know how important it is for a writer to travel? It's been my dream.
We earn our dreams in this world, Josephine. Foolish of me to never think I could change your ways.
I can try.
Never bend your will. You can never follow through. You can never bite your tongue, though your tongue may split in two. If you want to live your dreams, these are things you have to do. How could you change? You can't. Not you.
I could change if I wanted to.
Could you practice self-control? Could you possibly be shy? Could you wear a corset tight in the heat of mid-July? These are rules you must obey. It's everyone which you defy. You'll never change. You won't. That's why. Yet somewhere deep within my heart, I do believe you could captivate the world. Travel very far indeed. You could be beguiling someone well-mannered, a model of grace, learn the art of smiling.
That would be hard.
It isn't very hard for someone full of dreams like you. If you work, you'll find there's nothing you can't do.
So if I change, I'll go to Paris.
Change completely or don't waste my time.
If I change, we'll stop in Antwerp.
Gracious living will make you sublime.
If I change, you'll take me to Zurich.
Every city.
Takes to travel far.
Could
first ball, and it didn't look half so good on me. Margaret March, you've been dreaming of Annie Moffat's St. Valentine's Day ball for months now. You can't walk away from it.
I'm not going to pronounce.
You look very alluring.
I think the word you're looking for is alarming. Maggie's the beauty. Look at her. She'll be the most sought after girl at the ball.
She doesn't want to go.
Meg?
What will I do if someone asks me to dance? Just smile. And say, I'd be delighted, delighted, then offer him your hand. Delighted, delighted, now let him take command.
I'm hardly delighted,
you're dancing like a cat.
Think about what you said, and when Joe gets home, you can. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Mr. Rook, I want you.
Your grandfather will be furious. He wants to meet some very important people.
I have. These are the Marsh girls I've been telling you about from across the way. This is Meg, right?
Yes.
And this is Joe. She cuts our firewood on occasion. This is Mr. John Brook. He's a scholar from Boston.
I'm Lori Studer. Now call him Lori.
Sir, you've taken my dance card.
I've taken your dance card? Oh. Is this yours? So, you're Margaret March?
Yes, I am. So you're from Boston?
Actually, Maine.
Never been to Maine.
You should go. Very beautiful. Very primitive.
I like primitive.
Really?
Mr. Brook is a romantic.
Is he?
No, no, no. I read Sheets and Kelly. I mean, Keith and Shelley.
So do I.
You read Sheets and Kelly?
All the time.
You like the dance?
I'd be delighted.
But Meg, you were about to join the other ladies in the parlor.
Excuse us, Joe.
Across
We were dancing, and the ankle made me scream. Thank you.
Build up a wall between you and Amy now. and the ice is magnificent today.
Lori, I'm going to get the finishing touches on my story.
Finish it later. I want to win one race before the winter's over.
2 minute head start. Stupid.
2 minutes?
Go with them. Go anyway.
Where you're going. That piano sounds terrible.
It needs a tuning, sir.
Have you seen my grandson, Lori?
I'm sure he'll be home soon.
The boy's missed 6 lessons, fallen behind in all his work. I have strictly forbidden him to associate with this family.
Why, sir?
Because a man needs an iron will if he is to succeed in this world, and this family will only soften him. Which one of the dreadful little March girls are you?
I'm Dreadful Beth.
Ah, yes. Lori said you were the one that wanted to play my priceless piano. It's out of the question. The piano used to belong to my daughter, Lori's mother, and it's been locked up since she passed away. And that's how it shall stay. Are you afraid of me?
A little.
Why?
It might have something to do with your face, sir. It's very hard.
I cannot help my hard face. Continue what you were playing. Come now, I haven't all day. Are you going to play or not?
If you say come with me off to Massachusetts, then to Massachusetts we will go. We will buy dishes there, maybe even 2 sets. Buy the finest china, then we'll dine on wild grapes and zets.
Well, go on.
We will build model boats until the glue sets.
What's the matter now?
I don't remember the rest, sir.
Well, we wait with polka for the folk along the parapets.
Off
to Massachusetts.
Yes, we're off
to where the shops are sweet.
We will play minuet off in Massachusetts. Boston, Massachusetts, be repeat.
If you say come with me, come to Massachusetts, then to Massachusetts we will go. You will buy dishes nine in 2 sets. By the finest china, then we'll dine along with Christmas. Nuts.
Lori?
getting to the train.
Amy, darling, are you ready? Aunt March will be here soon.
Wait, you don't want to be late for the train.
I'm just waiting for Joe, so I'll be a few more minutes. Tell me I'm doing the right thing.
You're doing the right thing.
I've never left my girls before.
Your husband has pneumonia and needs you with him in Washington.
I feel like I'm being torn in two. One part of me here, the other part...
I'll check in on the girls every day.
Thank you, Mr. Lord.
I'll just take this to the carriage. Morning, Beth.
Morning, sir. I fixed you a basket of food.
Thank you, Beth.
Amy's almost ready. She's packing up half the house.
Where's Joe? I sent her to Aunt March's hours ago. She should be back by now.
I'll go find her.
It's the shawl Papa loves so much.
Mommy, please go get me my Aunt March's house.
I've been feeling so cold in it. I'm going to picture you with apple off in here. That's just for you. I feel father.
No, Amy. I'll see to it that you come. I'll go get the rest of you.
Carriage is ready, Mrs. March. Joe, you look different.
Mrs. March, we must be hurrying if we are to make it to the train.
By summer, I guarantee that every girl
will
come.
Come, let me know my girls.
We've never
been
parted before.
I feel
so
My dear Margaret, make sure your husband recovers.
Yes, Aunt March, I'll get to it. Thank you for taking Amy. Amy, tell Aunt March how excited you are to be staying with her.
Naturally.
No glum faces and no tears. I'll be back before you know. Why did you all go up so fast? Thank you, Aunt March. Goodbye.
Josephine, what have you done? You did what? I told you if you needed money, you come to me.
I'm hoping to earn my own money.
Selling your hair like a beggar is now no way for a lady to act. You look like a shorn sheep. You've forgotten our contract.
I would never forget. It's in Europe, Paris, London.
If you don't live up to your part of the bargain, why should I live up to mine? Well, let's just see what society thinks of your fire.
To hell with society.
Josephine!
We don't live for society. We live for what's inside of us. We live to expand our minds, fulfill our dreams, engage in passion.
That's enough. You think you know everything and you know nothing. As for Europe, you can forget it. Europe is meant for someone with a little more understanding of its rewards.
Please.
The subject is closed.
Thank you.
And just who is this?
He's Lori's tutor and a friend.
Well, tell your friend his visit should be brief. Amy, gather your things. I'll be waiting for you in the carriage. I have plans for you.
Yes, ma'am. John, what have you done?
I've enlisted. I couldn't stand by any longer. Your own father's in the Army Hospital in Washington. I have friends who will never return.
Where'd you go?
Tonight. Meg? Margaret? I'm not very rich. And I'm not particularly handsome.
You're very handsome, John.
Really? You think so? I'm not the wisest man.
You're very wise.
Thank you. Meg? Margaret? If you could find it in your heart, if you could love me as I love you, if only you'd care while we are apart, then I would be rich, I would be wise, I would be more than I am.
Please, will you return? Wait while you're at home.
If you go away while I, if you'll imagine me here with you, if only you care if I carry on, then I could be strong, I could be brave, I could be more, more than I am.
Thank you.
gall. A spinster rejected by the world. Hungry for blood. Rose from the dark. Joe March. Her hair, ghastly white. Her eyes, beady red. Joe, it's your best friend, Peter Lawrence the Third.
Glory, you haven't been here in weeks.
Joe,
We don't know. As your good friend, I think you'd be concerned for her.
We are not good friends. We're simply acquaintances.
I see.
You and the others in this boarding house think me and Miss Kirk have some sort of kinship. We have simply gone places together.
The theater?
Yes. I took her to see Hamlet.
A very pathetic tale it is.
Very good. And I have given her 3 journal lessons.
3? That many?
And I have taken her 2 lectures. To the park to hear speakers. But still, she barely notices I exist. She's preoccupied. She goes past me on the phone.
Miss Kirk, have you seen the professor?
I do.
Good day.
You'll never know your destiny.
Pilot Mask Assistance.
I have nothing left to give.
Give me your time.
My theta waits me.
Do you not care for me? It has been years since I felt the touch of a human hand. You have completed your journey. You may now return to the moors. Your fate is in your hands.
And Clarissa raced. She raced from the forest. She raced to the moors where she called. I have returned, Braxton. I will free the moors of your tyranny. Fight me!
I always knew you'd come back to me. They always do.
Clarissa thrusts. She parries. She backs up Braxton and pins him against a tree. She leaps up on a craggy rock, her sword swishing and swooshing. Never has she been so determined. She is on fire! Pity she hadn't taken dueling lessons. Out of nowhere, who should appear but the long-forgotten Rodrigo. This is your end, villain! I have waited a lifetime to destroy you!
Who are you?
I am your worst nightmare, Braxton! I am her sister!
And then Dashman got on his knees, crying, sell this to me, please.
Miss Mark!
Any order for more, now I'm ready for the weekly volcano press!
I'd like to accompany you.
I travel with you alone. Fine.
not travel alone.
I traveled here alone. I am fine.
Miss March. You'll be back?
Of course I will.
And Miss March, feel good.
Yes, I need good luck.
Heavy piece of wood. There. Got it.
Mr. Lawrence, it's time for him to sit. You shouldn't have.
But I did, and enough said on the matter. See you?
No.
I'm sorry. He's been moping about for weeks. I insisted he do some business for me, and then go to Europe and enjoy himself. And guess who he met up with in Florence? Amy, and your Aunt March. Miss March, may I join you?
It'd be an honor, sir.
If you say, come with me off to Massachusetts, then to Massachusetts, we will go.
Volatile exchange that we had. I miss...
I miss.
I'll walk some park to hear the speakers shout and change the world. I too would like to change the world. Yes, of course. She asks how I am.
Listen, Beth. I believe this one's 1,000 years old. Remember when you were young and we used to talk about coming to Cape Cod? And now Jo, with all her wee literary earnings, as she calls it, has brought us. I'm so glad to be here with you. Promise me, Beth. Whatever got hold of you, you'll continue to fight it.
Look what I got. A kite for my bed. Told me I wear all the colors of the rainbow for my sister.
That's the most beautiful kite I've ever seen. I shall leave you two. Stay. I'll go write a letter to Father and tell him how beautiful the Cape is this time of year. I love you.
Come out of the chair, Beth. Tell me about this kite together.
Tell me again about New York.
It's a circus.
A circus?
Dancing clowns, waltzing camels. Sometimes you see them right out on the street. And theaters, museums,
everywhere, Beth. And the women, are they shameless?
Some of them, anyway. I'm going to take you there.
To New York?
We'll go to my best restaurants, and we'll see Shakespeare, and we'll ride the omnibus.
Joe, I have something for you. Marmy says this shell is over 1,000 years old, and I believe that once upon a time, had an amazing life. If you put it up to your ear, it talks to you.
What does it say?
It says, we grow up too fast. You're a woman of the world now, Jill. I'm so proud of you.
Do you know what I told Marmy? When you were not an hour old,
Beth is mine.
Everyone has something special in the world. And I have you, my sweet Beth.
Give me a task to do. About what I wanted to do when I grew up, and
I'm not afraid to die.
The hardest part, Joe, is leaving you.
Don't let it happen. You'll be better. You will.
Some things are meant to be. The time turning endlessly. The way it takes hold of me. No matter.
We left it in shambles, and it's still in shambles.
Meg! Did you see the look I gave the coachman at March? His impertinent. Caught every bump in the road.
One must always be civil to a coachman, Amy. Respect those who have the reins, or you wrench the reins from them.
Yes, Aunt March. Joe! Marmee!
And remember, Amy, you're a lady now.
Yes, I'm a lady. Meg! When did this house get so small?
As we grow grand, the world around us often diminishes in size. I've seen people almost disappear before my very eyes.
You're such a dear Aunt March. Thank you for everything.
I'll go see to that wretched coachman.
Meg, 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 it's really you.
Look at me, too. Let me look at you.
Marmee. Oh, Mother, no, twins. I can't believe it.
Me either.
Amy!
Marmee, Marmee, Marmee.
My baby is home.
And look at you. You're all grown up.
I am. I really am. I'm sophisticated. I feel older. You can imagine all the experiences I had. And wherever I was, I think if only Meg were here, if only Joe, if only Beth,
Amy.
I was so sorry I couldn't be here to say goodbye to her. I cried for weeks. Aunt Martha said I was being unreasonable, but it broke my heart not to be here with her. Joe.
She said tell Amy not to fret.
Did she really say that?
She was so brave.
I bought her this metronome.
The man said there wasn't another like it. Where did we get this magnificent piano? He's such a dear, isn't he? It's so good to be here in our dear house.
Come, Amy, show us what you brought back.
It's a king's ransom. I have so much things to tell you all. I ate frogs, actual frogs. And John, is he so romantic?
More so.
I knew it. Men are so amazing.
It's almost everything.
Rory? I didn't know you were coming back.
Yes, we all sailed on the same ship.
You look different.
Do I?
I'm taller, an inch or so.
So nice of you to come for Amy and Aunt March during our last attempt.
When I heard the news, I was devastated. I didn't come to see you when I was in New York.
I wanted to. I thought of it.
I don't blame you. It was horrible for me. So unfeeling.
You said what you felt.
Guess what? I sold the story!
I knew you would. I always had that sort of faith in you, Joe.
I know you did.
You know, you look different too. Very distinguished.
I miss you.
I miss you too. And you know, I've learned something about myself.
What's that?
I was never meant to fly on golden wings.
With
you, Joe, you were meant to soar. Me, I was meant for more mundane things. I've decided to go into grandfather's business. I know it's the last thing in the world I would have thought for myself, but to be honest, I'm sort of fascinated with the prospects. I shall be wily and shrewd.
Lori, there you are.
Amy, did you tell Joe?
The most amazing thing.
Really quite a thing.
You tell her.
No, you tell her.
All right, I'll tell her. We were under the bridge of sighs.
In a gondola.
Under Italian skies.
Lullabies.
He said he likes the way I sing.
The day was ours.
We talked for hours.
It was amazing.
I said I love fireflies.
I said so do I.
I told him I hate goodbyes.
There was something in her eyes.
I swear that bells begin to ring.
Amazing, there we were in Venice.
In a gondola.
In Venice.
When he suddenly stood up
and shouted,
will you marry me? It was so romantic.
Then I fell into the water.
And before we even knew it,
she dove in and rescued me.
It happened before we knew.
How could we have known?
Amazing what time can do.
From that moment my heart flew.
We'll be married in the spring. Whoever thought in all the world we'd fall in love, and yet we did. It was amazing.
Amazing.
Amazing. The most amazing thing. Get the other half on our next trip. And later, Aunt March wants to speak to us about proper wedding etiquette.
Well, Lori,
welcome to the family.
Thank you, Joe.
I never meant for things to happen like this. I always thought of Lori as yours.
It's never been mine. Only the one of us.
Joe, I brought this for you. It's a book of all my drawings. All the things you should have seen. All the churches and palaces and mountains. I want you to have it.
I can.
Yes, you can. We'll be close, Joe. That'll never change.
Never. Thank you, Amy, and your drawings are beautiful.
Have got to learn something. How can I give her any less? I want life to go on. I want days of plenty. You have to believe there is reason for hope.
several days before Christmas, when the sisters sat about the parlor and grumbled about their fate. Meg, the oldest and most romantic, said, "It's not fair that some girls have pretty things, while we have nothing. And it won't be Christmas without presents," said Amy with her usual pout.
"And we have no father to read to us," said Joe, who yearned to travel and write great books.
Only Beth, sitting contented, said, in a voice so sweet, even angels would have listened, "But we've got each other." "Everything I promised them is here. All of us know the way we used to be. We will always have each other. They will always be the fire in my heart. Here I go, and there's no turning back. My great adventure has begun. I may be small, but I've got giant plans to shine as brightly as the sun. Here in all the smallest details,
they will be magnificent. Soon Lori and Amy will be wedded bliss.
Meg, look at me. I can't get married looking like this. This dress is not very tranquil.
The dress is very tranquil.
Amy, calm. Let me finish your hair.
I made all the wrong decisions for the wedding, Marmy. This dress, those flowers.
Oh, you look like Madonna.
Merci, John. It was all Lori's idea to have the mansion of the very petite mission, and I can deny one more nothing.
Why is she speaking French?
Is I this bad on our wedding day?
Worse.
John!
You were inspiring.
A telegram from her father. It's at the station. Just call me up there.
3 sets of silver, 2 sets of dishes, 16 chairs, 4 cut glass bowls, and all of my flowers from my conservatory. I have been joyfully divested of all of my worldly belongings. Where's Amy?
You're not to see her before the wedding.
I know. Grandfather, here's the champagne you asked for.
I'll take that. I'm off to the train station.
Come, let's have a cigar before the ceremony begins. So, you ready to be a bridegroom?
My life has never been more complete, and the rain has held up.
Where is Josephine?
I'll go find her.
And tell Peg I wish to speak to her about receiving line etiquette. The cream of the Concord will be here any minute.
I understand. I suppose you realize this could have been your day.
And you think I made a guess?
I do not. Amy and Lori are ideally suited for each other. I've got another level.
And March, I don't.
Meg can go with Harry, most of my money. Amy won't need any of it, and she's making her way into society. As for you...
Aunt March! I know. You don't want anything, and yet you want everything.
Every girl, every woman, deserves something to fall back on when times are bleak. I'm leaving to you my house.
Your house?
Do something worthwhile with it. Like a school or a library.
That's very generous of you, Aunt March.
Thank you.
I don't like that dress.
It was yours.
It looked better.
Has a strange man asked him through at the gate?
Professor Bear?
Hello.
Hello. Is this a surprise?
You wrote if I should ever come north, I should come visit you.
Yes, but...
You never thought I would come, did
no.
you?
No.
Well, I'm here. Should I go?
No. Come inside. I'll introduce you.
No, not yet.
So, how's Miss Kirk?
As impossible as ever.
And the Mourners?
As strange as ever.
And you?
Me. The same.
There's no one whose opinion I respect more than yours, sir, but excuse me for presuming.
I brought your manuscript back. It was really nice of you to send me a book. A novel?
There's no one whose opinion I respect more than yours.
It touched me deeply. I heard your voice. I felt your touch. It was magnificent.
No, Amy is trying to be insane. Now she's talking about changing her veil.
This is my sister Meg. This is Professor Bear.
Ah, yes, the one from her story.
So you're the one she lets read them.
I'll be right there.
Have I come at a bad time?
No, it's just a wedding.
A wedding?
I often think about you, Professor.
I bought a kite.
A kite?
Soon after you left, I bought a kite. I took it to the park. I never had a kite. You're right to the council.
You're not old.
I was. But since we have met, things are different. Everybody has noticed. They say, Professor Bear, you were smiling today. Miss March.
Joe.
We have our differences. We are nothing alike. May I be blunt?
Be blunt, by all means.
I think perhaps it looks like rain.
The sky gets bluer by the hour.
Waterfalls and little drops.
That's why it's called a sun shower.
Oh, and now it stops.
You were about to be blunt.
If I say rain, then you say sun. If I say yes, then you say no. It seems before we start, we're done. We even argue at hello. If I say share this small umbrella.
I say who cares if I get wet.
We are as different as the morning and the night.
No, we're as different as the winter and the spring.
We always seem to fight.
We disagree on everything.
And yet,
family gathered in the parlor. And just who are you?
Aunt March. Professor Bear.
Call me Fritz.
Fritz? Is that your name? Fritz?
Did I not tell you?
No.
Well, bring in Fritz.
You were saying Fritz?
When people discover passion, they come upon something rare. The fur that I have in common will shelter them anywhere. Though the mess may be rough, with such passion to share, I think we have more than enough. Enough to make a marriage if we dare.
You are proposing?
No. Yes, yes. I do not mean today or tomorrow or any next month. In a year maybe, 2 years. I am a patient man.
I won't be sweet, I won't be dear.
This I purr, this I adore.
I'll speak my mind, you can be sure.
I'll be enchanted to the core.
If I say let me share your small umbrella,
I'll say who cares if we get well.
Particularly outspoken one. He'd like to publish it.
Did he really say that?
If it's okay with you.
Joe?
Marmy,
we need you inside.
Marmy, this is Professor Fritz Bear. He's a friend of mine. He's going to be staying with us for a while. We're thinking about starting a school together. Not today, or next week.
Welcome, Professor. Come meet our family.
Sometimes when you dream, your dreams come true. In extraordinary ways, suddenly a day can be so amazing. And sometimes when you
waiting for you.